Hey, Meshmaker, welcome. Twitch is weird. What happened? Oh, I see. Yeah, I've actually had the same problem yesterday. Wow, so many deer! Oh my goodness! But there is no bear. Oh yes, there is a bear. Thanks. Welcome. Yeah, it has been somehow not working very well, Twitch. Yeah, it does that every now and then. You notice that it looks much closer like this than like that.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm gonna use a hook. Let's put on a fire. Could have saved that bullet. But what is the fun in doing that? Run up to him? I don't know. That might not have been a very good idea. I only trust it when he's dead. You know, when I was doing the speed crafting in Mystery Lake, I thought the bear was dead in its cave, and I went right next to it and I was about to put on the fire and he got up. They've got a bad binding. They are actually paperbacks, the one in the game. So they don't even count as a binding. Let's go and get the second bear. Once we got the second one, then I can start thinking about repairing my clothing and all that sort of stuff. I woke up with a terrible headache this morning. Not entirely sure what it is. I think I'm gonna grab a second coffee right now because it's kind of bad. gonna drop everything in here and then go for the second bed. It should be up there. So it's actually good that there are no wolves around here for now. They're gonna come for sure, but they are on the lake, so that's pretty good for me now. I can repair this for now, so I'm gonna put them in there. That's nice. Unfortunately, I don't have much wood on me. Oh, that's very nice. Look at that. Am I warming up in here? Yeah, okay, good. Guys, I'm gonna grab that coffee. I'll be right back. should have tried with a stick. Reclaiming the wood is very difficult. Is the most difficult to start a fire with. I'm gonna put the height down first. Because that's more important, that it starts curing. So from now I've got where are we at? 1 day, 22 hours. Then from tomorrow we'll start on the wolf pelts. I've got to take a couple of scraps of meat from these bear. Tony, hey, welcome. Tony, I'm doing a, as promised, the speed crafting in Coastal Highway. I've already got the two bears. That's my first day. think of 3 hours. It'd be nice to have a knife. I think I might want to make a trip by the workbench, because for sure there is a knife there. With 3 hours to go, might be enough to get. Got 2 hours. I'm gonna make my way towards the workbench, because the knife is gonna allow me to harvest much faster. I'll check that on the way back. Is there a reason why I chose Coastal Highway? Not really. It's just because I've done Mystery Lake in 13 days, under 14 days. So the next natural one is Coastal Highway. I'm just doing them in order, really. It's not a particular reason. Katsu, welcome. How are you, Katsu? I'm gonna harvest these tomorrow though. Because I'm gonna have a knife. Confining. I'm doing a speed crafting challenge. Eye shifting. Craft every single item in the game as fast as you can. So it will be all the clothing items, including the bare bedroll. Wait, did I miss? I did. Should have checked the frozen guy up here. Sometimes has got ammo. I got distracted from that wolf. It sounds hard. Well, I've done. It's not that hard. It's actually much easier than an outdoor challenge, for instance. It's just a matter of doing it under 14 days. Because to cure bear hides takes 12 days. So I've already got the two bears on my first day. Now, on the second day, tomorrow, I'm gonna have to start on the wolf pelts. Because those, they take 7 days to cure. And then the deer hides. And the last one will be the rabbits. How many things? Well, there is the wolfskin coat, the trousers and the boots, the bedroll, and the mittens. Plus, I think I'm gonna do the bow and arrow as well. So the reason why I've come all the way down here is because I don't have a knife, and the knife allows me to harvest hides and pelts and guts much faster. So I had to harvest the two bears with my hatchet. And it takes much longer, especially on the guts. I've also got an idea for a challenge that I've done in the past. I've called it the Valentino Challenge, but it was to craft 10 copies of each item. And I did it in a couple of hundred days, I remember. But I wanna redo that. And trying to do it with a better time. So I might think about that. Okay, good. I have to do a little management here. I need tinder plugs. And I have to repair some of my clothing. Also, I still don't have... Okay. I don't have any bandages. That was quite risky of me not to do that beforehand. Okay. Don't know. Maybe it's not very convenient to harvest this when I've got Johnny Bumpkins, thank you so much for the host. That's very kind of you. Thank you. I don't think it's worth it to actually harvest this when I've got the curtains. That is a much better value. for 6 minutes for two of them, and it's a much, much better value. You just started playing this game. I think I've seen you streaming earlier. I kind of recognize your name. How is it? How do you like The Long Dark? Johnny, this is not the conventional way of playing the game, because I'm doing a challenge with self-imposed rules. Essentially, I'm speedcrafting. I'm speedcrafting Vortox. Welcome. And Johnny, thank you so much for the follow. So I'm gonna try and craft every single item in the game, the clothing items, as fast as I can. Now the bedroll, the bear hides, they take 12 days to cure. So the aim here is to craft everything under 14 days. I've already got the two bear hides. I got them on my very first day. And this is the second day, the one I'm approaching. So it's going pretty well so far. You died 12 days to cure the hides, yes, the bear hides. There is crafting in this game. If you just started, maybe you are not entirely aware of it, but you can craft better clothing from the pelts, wolf pelts and deer hides. I'll show you on the workbench as soon as we get there. So let's eat and drink. You died on your 11th day. What difficulty were you playing on? No, I mainly stream The Long Dark. Okay, there is a bear outside. I'm gonna take one more hour's sleep just to try and get rid of that bear. It's in a very awkward position, so I can't shoot it right now. It's way too close. Which reminds me, I could actually do some cleaning. You were on Mystery Lake and the Norma on Voyager, but that's pretty good, 11 days for your first try. If it's on Voyager, it means wildlife is gonna attack you. This is on Stalker, obviously. I've just finished yesterday an outdoor only challenge because I only do challenges now. I don't really like to survive as long as I can because I've done it before. I went for 1,300 days. I didn't die, I just got really bored. Okay, we need wolf pelts. Yeah, it's Voyager, the mid difficulty. Yeah, 1,300 days, and I gave up. I just couldn't do it anymore. But that was long ago, before the last three big updates. So now I do all sorts of different challenges to keep interested in the game, obviously. Mr. Penguin, I think it's great, it is, but it's a great game. I mean, especially because the sandbox is so nicely open that you can make up your own challenges. Okay, today we need to pick up 4 wolf pelts. So let's just do that. It's all about, on this particular challenge, it's all about prioritizing what you need. The bear hides, they were the first thing I needed because they take much longer to cure. Second in line is wolf pelts. India! Oh my goodness, how are you? I'm very well, nice to see you. It's been a while. Okay, I've got 2 wolves here. It's fairly cold. How much wood do I have? Very little. Okay, so I've got to pick up a few sticks. Then I'm gonna grab that wolf. Actually, you know what? Take one of these. So I'm gonna try and take this wolf next to the other one. with one fire, I should be able to pick up both of them. Okay, Johnny, thank you so much for the host, and hopefully I'll see you soon. How did I miss? Wow, that was a very glitchy wolf. Come on, don't go too far. Come back. Yeah, that was a glitchy wolf. He didn't like it. Cabbage, please. Thank you so much for the follow. Let's forget about that guy. And Mr. Penguin, thank you so much for the follow. A small break before summer school, India. Oh, good. Oh yes, many people they mention Minecraft when they see this game. I've never played Minecraft myself, so my hand seems cold. Might be. It was one of the Matrix. You reckon, Mr. Penguin, that this has the same potential as Minecraft? Minecraft is a huge game. Lots of people play Minecraft. Well, it is kind of old in a sense that has been out for a very long time. Yeah, it's not very popular right now, but I agree, it's got potential. Where is that wolf gone? Maybe I shouldn't mind too much about that wolf. I'm gonna have so many by the gas station. So I'm just gonna carry on. It's not really worth it for me to go and look for that wolf. I haven't checked that fishing hut, and I haven't checked that one. But my priority for now is wolf pelts, so I'm gonna leave those for later on. There should be a deer hide, a deer carcass here. So I'm gonna grab these for now. Yeah, but World of Warcraft is, it's a much bigger game. And has evolved so much throughout the years. Look, I got a spare hatchet. Nice. Yeah, Mr. Penguin, you know what I think? And this is because of most of the comments I get in chat. on a regular basis, they ask for a co-op. And in my opinion, this game is beautiful because of the single player. But the new generation of players, they are so used to co-ops that they look at games that way. They look at games to have fun with friends. So this game is very unlikely that it's ever gonna have a co-op, unless they completely change or redesign the game, which will actually transform it into something else. But yeah, that's the only thing that I can see can hold it back. The new generation doesn't socialize in real life. Right, the second day was not as successful as the first one, but we got 2 deer hides, which is enough for the trousers, the boots, I mean. Hey, Sweet for Victory, hi. Yeah, co-op games are appealing. I can see that. I understand that side of it. Yeah, that's what I meant, Enix. That's what. That's the reason why I said is probably the only thing I can see that can hold it back to spread in popularity. Yeah, don't get me wrong, I'd love to see this game going getting popular, but yeah, we'll see. Hopefully, it's very appealing game. Visually, it's just stunning. Okay, let's get it to 100% so we can forget about it. Cleaning kit is ruined, so put it in there. Perfect. I'm not gonna need that. So we need to go out and grab wolf pelts, right? We got wood. Make a couple of more bandages. Oh, I should repair some of my clothing, shouldn't I? That leaves us with 10 hours, almost 10 hours to go, which is perfect. And off we go. What happened to all the wolves? This is odd. It's a bit, maybe it's too early. I'll take the damage. It's very odd. They have completely disappeared. Usually this place is full of wolves. Oh, there you are, finally. Oh, there is another one there. Okay, good. thing is, when I shoot one of these, that's why the bow is a much better weapon. Not just because it's lighter, but it doesn't scare off the other ones, because now the other ones, they're gonna run. Look at that. That guy's running. That one was our second fault. And this is our third. We need one more after this. Birth control. Hey, hi. How are you? The speed crafting, yes, it's a self-imposed challenge, birth control. Trying to craft everything under all the clothing items under 14 days. You know that the bear hides, they take 12 days to cure. So I had to get the first two bears on the very first day. Oh, great, Mr. Penguin. That sounds good. Okay, we need one more wolf. And I don't see any around, so got to go on the ice. See if there is any around. Less snow. Oh, I don't have any water. What we got? 8 hours. It's a bit of a shame that there are no wolves around. Maybe... Oh, there it is. There is one there. I was saying this is a self-imposed challenge, so you don't find the challenge implemented in the game. In the game, there are only two challenges for now: the hopeless rescue one and the haunted, which is the bear challenge. These challenges. Oh, look at this! How sneaky are these dogs? Look at this. All right. Okay. That's fair enough. Did you see how many? Sneaky dogs. You cannot ever trust wolves. I don't know why I shot that wolf. I should have saved that rifle round. I know, right? There were no wolves when I first moved in. Boomtown. Hey, welcome. Oh, you had a 9 hour stream. Oh my goodness. That's a long stream. That's what I don't understand, when they take such a route over the rocks, what is all that about? Still 4 hours. I've got my other two wolf pelts just by the door, so I might as well try and get more deer hides. What do I think about a game mode that generates random map? I actually thought about it. I thought it would be really nice to have some random maps. I would love that. Every time there is a new map coming out, it's really exciting because it feels like going back at the beginning when I picked up the game. You don't know where you are, and that feeling of being lost is priceless, really. I think I'm gonna save the bullet, because I've got a feeling I got this deer pretty good, and he's gonna bleed out any second now. I'm not very cold, so I can wait it out. Just want to make sure that, oh, there it is, it's going down. This is going to give me food as well, which is great. Offset, hey, welcome. You didn't miss much. We are on the first couple of days, I think. Let's check that. Third day. So I've collected a number of hides and pelts already. I've got the two bear hides already curing, so it's looking good. So I'm gonna need only one more deer hide and then the rabbits. Well, the rabbits are easy. So tomorrow we'll go and grab the deer hide over there. Actually, I should leave this meat outside. For now, I don't need to cook it right now. Okay, good. We are doing very well, guys. I'm gonna grab a coffee and then we'll go and grab the deer hide. I'll be right back. Okay, let's go and see. I don't have any suggestion for you, Bottom Town. Sorry. I mean, I do have a suggestion, but I'd rather not say it. Anyway, good luck with the streaming. I really hope you are gonna do well. Hey, Tornhammer, Amora. A knife maker can come and help you out, Boomtown, in your own stream. Okay? Yeah, knife maker, you can go and help him out in his own stream. Thank you so much. All is well. Boomtown, it's okay. I think it's fine now, okay? It's enough. Shifty, good stuff, Bottom Town. Thank you so much for dropping in. You got chips. With the latest update, well, what I really like is the new lighting indoor. They've done a great job with that. especially in the morning when the sun comes out, you can really now tell the difference. Oh, the arc. Oh, I was wondering what that meant. I thought it stood for something, but I couldn't quite work it out. We have tested the parasites. I've done a run just testing that mechanic. And honestly, it's going to be very difficult for experienced player to actually contract parasites. I didn't mean to eat all of it. But it is very expensive to cure. I mean, it's gonna eat your supplies of antibiotics. We did it over the 5 maps, so we had so many mushrooms. And I still actually have the safe, because then I kind of, you know, after 70 days I got bored. But it's an interesting mechanic. There is obviously a way to contract parasites much easier, much faster than if you eat normally, but it's really asking for it, essentially. You keep nibbling on the same piece of meat over and over, and that increases the risk enormously. But if you eat once a day, and then it's really difficult to get parasites, because by the time you eat the day after, the risk is already gone, has already reset. Shame I didn't take my what's called the primer, because that car can have ammo in the trunk. As per the cabin fever, I've actually never managed to get any, but I guess it's because of my game style. Being outdoor becomes very difficult for cabin fever to show up. The new graphics, they are excellent. They've done a really great job. Okay, let's put down this, and I think we got enough time, 7 hours, to go and look for saplings. Okay, so we got the boots, trousers, coat, and bedroll. Really. Yeah, sticks are OP. You still refuse to break down branches? It is a bit more convenient now because they give out three sticks instead of the two. So it's not that bad now. It was very expensive before to, you know, to spend 10 minutes for two sticks. It is worth now if you are in need, yeah, because according on what you got, for instance, it takes 5 minutes with a hatchet and 10 by hand. No saplings. I was hoping for some birch saplings up there, but if they are not there, that means they are by the very beginning of the map, so gonna go there some other days. The Timberwolf Mountain has lower food decay. No. The food decay doesn't it's not related to the map where you are. Now with the update, they've also changed that. But even before the update, it was the same in every map. Now, no, it's the same, India. Maybe it's a bug that you got, but. Okay, Amar, thank you so much for dropping in. I'm gonna end the stream real soon. Gonna cook the meat, and this will be probably the last day. I've already collected all the hides and pelts I need, and in tomorrow's stream, I'm gonna craft all the items. Oh, thanks, Amara. That's very sweet of you. No, but India, now the food, if you store it outdoor, degrades at much slower pace. But that's in every map. Maybe you'll find that in Timberwolf, you just noticed that in Timberwolf because there is no indoor location there. So that's probably the reason why. But it's the same in every map. If you put the food outdoor, it's gonna last forever now. I mean, not forever, but for a very long time. Before, you could store it in a container indoor, and it would last very long. Now, you have to store it outdoor. I thought you said pre-update, that's why I answered that way, but this is post-update, essentially. Offset, welcome back. I'm actually about to sign off because I've been streaming already for more than 3 or 4 hours, and this was gonna be a small stream because I'm busy today. Guys, thank you so much for dropping in, and most of all, thank you very much for all the follows and the hosts. I really appreciate that. We got the bear hides already 32% cured, and we are on day 4, so that's pretty good. On day 12, these are gonna be ready for crafting. This is also going well. So, yeah, everything is coming up nicely. We got everything we need except for the 4 rabbit pelts, which is gonna be very easy to get hold of. But for now, I'm gonna call it, and hopefully I'll see some of you back tomorrow.